Hello there, gamers. Gondor here, and welcome back to Hyrule Warriors. Last time we done the Farron Woods, where the woman in question was not Princess Zelda, but rather the white sorceress Lana. So she is now joining with us on our quest to find Princess Zelda. But at first, we're going to have to go through the next level, which is the Valley of Seers.
Ooh.
Yes. Ooh, scary. Not really, considering all my characters. Well, not all of them, but some of them. Well, we'll say about 90% of them are pretty strong, apart from most of the DLC ones who are still very, very low level.
Well, considering between the episodes here, they took a look at how strong the characters are.
Yeah.
It turns out Link isn't the strongest character.
Yes, it's Lana.
Lana's level 95.
Yeah. Well, in any case, let's... Right, wait. Okay, now...
Because as you can see,
level 91 and level 95. Yeah, with Lana being the only character who has started her third row of hearts.
Yes. So she's a wee bit overpowered.
Yeah.
So I'm going to stick with Link.
Stick with Link, okay. And your recommended weapon's either the spinner or the gauntlets. But no, you're still going to stick with the Master Sword.
Naturally. So that means if you want, you can play as Lana for this one.
Maybe,
or
but
play
no.
DLC.
No, right. I think I'll stick with a few of the DLC characters.
Oh, hold on.
Yeah, now don't worry, I've already pressed... Oh yeah, you want to change Link's costume, yes. You want to take Link's shirt off and see him in his sumo outfit, which unfortunately you don't get to see him in his sumo outfit, and this one only in Twilight Princess, which is the only time for you ever do see Link without a shirt on, and you get to see his lovely little six-pack body. Until Breath of the Wild comes out, in which case you can have shirtless Link if you so wish.
You fantasize in there, Gordon?
Oh yeah.
As long as it's good fun, I suppose.
Yeah, you know. Link is my Romeo.
Not a lot of people are going to get that reference, you know that.
But in any case. Right, so did you pick your outfit?
Yep.
Okay. And me, I think I will go for the Italian name, minus one letter. Ravioli. Or in this case, Ravio, who is dark element. And he wields rental hammers. Yeah, not just a hammer, since Darunia wields... Oh, well, he also wields hammers, but Ravio wields these kind of hammers. Right, so I think I will use the nice hammer. It doesn't look very nice.
Well, it's a nice thing to see.
Yeah, even...
It's got the logo of the...
Well, yeah, it's got the Triforce on it. The leader of the Resistance. What is this, Star Wars? R.I.P. Carrie Fisher? Who had summoned the monsters
to Hyrule. Lana had been fighting. God damn it, 2016.
Yeah. Sia now sought to complete the Triforce and use Yeah, it and speaking of Hyrule. The loss of celebrities, I think it's actually David Bowie's birthday today as well. Yeah, since we are playing this on the 8th, and I think he died on the 10th of January, which is 2 days from now.
Every day, we knew he was born on the 10th. You said died.
Yeah, he died on the 10th, but he was born today, on the 8th of January.
Never mind.
I know what I said. Stop trying to confuse me.
Never said anything.
Whatever. Whatever, let's just start the battle.
I'm just having a wee look at the map. I'll head...
So, which way?
Left.
Alright, then.
Get most of that map, bit of the map done.
Yeah.
Well, what way do I need to go, basically?
Well, I know that we do need to head towards the right, but because we've already got the boomerang, there are a few shortcuts where we can just go straight by. So, if you see vines sticking out from the ground, you can use the boomerang and just cut right through them.
Right.
You know, because we've already got... Well, I've already got the boomerang.
Mirahan?
Right, so I'm gonna swap to the boomerang and I will head over this way.
I've just realised we're both wearing purple.
Oh, so you're wearing a purple Link's outfit.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, we are both purple. You know that Link's not really a darkness character. Oh yeah, and also Ravio doesn't also use hammers. If you combine his attacks, he can use other things like the water rod and the gale boomerang. And possibly some bombs. He used to roll a bomb.
Yeah. Oh. Is, I don't think he's up to this point.
No. Oh, Empa changed route. Rival's now level 4. I wonder how many levels Radio will get to before this mission's over.
Yep, we are playing on hard, so...
Yep, which means more EXP for my characters.
That's why I think you take center stage, because if you're playing with a weaker character, you're going to get the most benefit for it.
Yep. Oh, we need to capture two vital keeps, the East Keep and the West Keep. So uh-huh. Seeing...
I'll handle the...
Oh. Yeah, watch out for these things. You use bombs to take care of those.
Can you just slice them to bits?
No. See? I am trying to attack it with my hammer and no counter. These are Beamos. Any legend or Zelda player should know that the only way to take out Beamos is to chuck bombs at him.
As you know, I'm more a legend Zelda player.
Yeah.
I'm not against the series.
Yep. Yeah, like a level 5 already. Oh cool, I've got Sheik with me. Maybe, but so far I've not taken any damage. Or if I have, then I've probably picked up a few hearts. Right, well that's the East Keep taken. Because when I find it, I'm gonna find that keep boss and I'm gonna kill it. Oh, I see some vines. And I don't mean the internet things. There we go. But unfortunately that leads to a locked gate that we can't open yet. We can only open that, I think, from the other side. So I'm going to need to wait until you take out the West Keep.
Doing that just now.
Alright. Okay. Right, I'll just take out some of these because I need to wait until you've taken over that keep before we can continue.
Looks like there's a keep with some enemies on the route to south.
Yeah, I see it. I'm just taking out most of these creatures. Yeah, let's use Ravio's A spell. He uses the bomb arrow combination with. Well, I'm probably guessing the Gale Hammer. Sorry, not Gale Hammer, the Gale Boomerang. Because there is no such thing as a Gale Hammer in Legend of Zelda. At least not yet.
I just sword special the treasure chest that I got.
Why would you want to do that?
I have no idea.
Oh dear, it looks like Sheik's in trouble.
See what I mean? We're both in red and purple.
Yep, except mine looks like a rabbit suit. Even though that when Ravio was first introduced in A Link Between Worlds, many people thought it was Nabbit from New Super Mario Brothers.
I can see why the similarities there.
Yeah. Except that it has been confirmed by Nintendo that Ravio and Nabbit are two completely different people.
But that then again, help him.
Yeah. But then again, you know, Nintendo can use whatever they want to base their characters off of.
Yeah.
Right, where am I? I'm there. Oh, okay, I have now just noticed that both of us have now swapped sides.
Yeah, I'm taking on Vulgar.
Alright, Vulgar?
That dragon knight.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Red Cane for Final Fantasy.
Yeah, Vulgar the Vulgar. In fact, yeah, just Vulgar the Vulgar. Sounds like something out of a MMO.
And I just only slashed them.
Yeah, another level up. Hmm. You know, I wonder if it's possible if you can turn the camera in such a way that you can actually see underneath Ravio's hood in this game. Even though that I know who Ravio looks like, and just before this episode started I showed you who Ravio is.
A bit of pasta.
Yeah. Ravioli, he is a living piece of pasta. Yeah, you got a piece of pasta. Well, wait a minute, he's... His name almost sounds Italian, so he's secretly Mario. You know, almost similar to that Pianta guy from Super Mario Sunshine, the one who likes to challenge Mario to races. Then you find out that that's actually the running man slash postman from the Legend of Zelda. Right, there should be a bridge guy to help us on the right hand side.
Not the King of Cornelia?
No, not that guy. Because if you look at the map near the bottom right hand corner, there's, it looks like there's a
speech bubble.
No, well, whoa. Ah, yeah, here we are. Escort the engineer.
I'll take care of this, but if you want, you can do this.
Needs to be over here. So where I am, this is where you need to escort the engineer, and I can see the engineer.
Our forces are moving towards
the
engineer.
Yep, the faction of forces is headed towards our engineer.
I think I've took out half of them already.
Yeah. In fact, it looks like the engineer can easily make it there without any problems whatsoever. But still, I'm gonna stick with him. Okay, I don't even know if the Triforce on that hammer is supposed to be like that, or if it's just the light from in-game shining on it.
I'm guessing in-game.
Right, come on, engineer, would you hurry up? I have a big spiked hammer here and I'm not afraid to use it.
Should we just start calling you MC?
Yeah. Come on.
MC Gondor.
Yeah. MC Ravio, who wears a purple bunny suit with a scarf. And just wields a hammer. Come on! Ugh. Thank you. Come on, there is literally nothing here, so why are you stopping? Come on, you're almost there. Okay, here's some dark forces. I can take care of these guys. Okay, there we go. Right. Engineer is almost there. I think I can let him be for now. Yep, there we go. Mission successful. So hopefully, well, in fact, not hopefully, he will lower that bridge to get us onto the opposite side of the map. Right, so the engineer is now going to withdraw. Okay, I'm now on the other side. Oh, look at Darknut. Oh, a summoner. Stay away from the summoner! Oh, where did the Darknut go?
You probably killed him.
I doubt it, but okay.
I just flung a Darknut out while he keeps by using my special.
Oh, I found treasure chest. Probably gonna be full of rupees. Yep.
I'm gonna have rupees.
Right, so where's the summoner? Unless it's at the summit. So yeah, so basically that's where we need to go now, the summit.
Right. I'll head up the left side.
Yeah, I'm gonna take out most of these outpost captains while I'm here. Cut down the vine wall and go to the summit.
I'm taking care of the west temple as we speak.
Alright. I'll get rid of some of these guys with my rolling bombs. I'm gonna go and take a take this keep, this eastern room. Alright, need a big group of them. Yeah, this one will do it.
As we capture the west keep, or west temple.
Okay. Eastern room's almost taken. Oh, another Beamos. Another level up.
Seven.
Yep. I have no idea. Sometimes I don't pay attention to what levels I get. Right, yeah, I think,
I'll get that keep if you want.
Oh, Yeah, well, wait a minute, wasn't there, like, vines blocking the way? Oh well, in any case... What, are you next to a closed gate?
Yeah,
don't worry, I'm already inside the keep which opens that gate, so... If you stay there, I can open it for you. Yeah, got dart nut again. Right, key boss has appeared, and there we go, the gate should open soon.
Uh oh.
What? Is there something nearby? What?
The gate's not open yet.
Well, it should open soon.
I'm gonna make a quick.
There we go, it's open.
I'm gonna make a quick detour back to our main base of operations.
Alright. Well, I'm going to head towards the summit, which means that there's probably going to be a cutscene soon. Ah, yeah, these are the vines I was looking for. So I'm going to get rid of these ones, and I'll get rid of the ones on the other side. I don't know why, but there's something so satisfying just watching your boomerang chase after you and then hit everything along the way. Just the way Ravio's... Oh my god, there's a lime bag on my boomerang! Run away! Right, I'm going to head up to the summit now. Violet Link.
Who's me?
Yep. And this time, Ganondorf does not have the Triforce of Power. This time it's this person, Sia. Yeah. And yet with an outfit like that, it still amazes me how Nintendo manages to get away with it. Yeah, considering what they've done to the Great Fairy and Twilight Princess. Yeah. I'm not going to mention why, but just in case if anyone decides to look it up, you'll see why. Oh, another cutscene. Oh, it's oh, time to get manhandled! Yum, 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 yum. The poisonous tree. Yep, the poisonous tree. Manhandler. Yes, I know it's actually spelled manhandler, not manhandler. And I don't even know why I'm... Oh, manhandlers made a seed attack on the allied base. Right, and if you can't remember how to take out the manhandler, wait until it changes its colour to green and then chuck a boomerang at it.
Oh, I'm going to hold them back to take care of this attack,
you know? Alright, well, I'm going to take out this ruined summit, although I can't remember if I can capture this ruined summit, but I'm going to keep it. Oh, yes, it looks like I can. Awesome. Yep, because it gives us a treasure chest. Right, where is it? There it is. And it is... rupees! Right, I'm going to take care of Manhandler.
Oh, but I'm here just to help you clean up the
I know,
minutes.
Yeah, well, I can
We're
see...
We're doing the main story.
Well, I can see that there's an outpost on the far right-hand corner of the map that's not been taken yet.
Be red, but
you can tell where it is because it looks like there's a diamond on it.
Right. Going there just now.
It uses bullet seed.
This isn't flowy.
I was thinking of a Pokemon. Since when did Flowey use bullet seed?
It's the first attack he uses on you.
Well, seriously, it's actually called bullet seed.
Well, it doesn't actually have a name, but you. If you play Undertale, it's the first thing you use against you. And if you tell you to get into it,
yeah.
And if you do, well. Yeah.
Right, come on, hopefully that should take care of the sweet point. Yep, there we go.
I'm going to take care of the sweet point.
Alright. Right, I think I'll probably want to use. Ragnar's magic layer. Oh, manhandler's using dig. So there you go, manhandler knows two Pokemon moves, Bullet Seed and Dig. But where is he going to pop up? Because he's going to split himself into four with each one of his faces coming up at separate places. Right, so we're just going to need
five heads.
Yep.
Well, like four.
Well, maybe one of them's real and the others are fake. So I'll take care of this one. Yeah, just use the boomerang to take him down. My handless dog has been defeated. Yeah, I think we need to take them all down, because I don't think this is one of these ones where, like, find the real one amongst the fake. Oh, this one almost used Bullet Seed on me. Right, so you're next to the last one. Okay, good, you got it.
He's going to resurface again.
Yep, he'll resurface somewhere, probably on one of the bigger sections of the map, or basically where he was before. Oh, in fact, right next to you. Okay. Right, there we go. Wait until his core is shown first. Okay.
He's on Martwood.
Yep, and there we go. That is this mission done now. So let's see. Is there a way I can like manipulate the camera so I can see what's under Rabio's hood? Probably not.
No, because it's just a big shady darkness.
Yeah, kind of on the summit Organization 13's hoods. Wait, where's Admiral Akbar?
It's a trap!
No, my triangles.
Thank you.
Oh dear, we no longer have our Triforce PCs. Yep, but aren't you supposed to use the Triforce to grant a wish, not use it for like, well, epic evil power? Oh, we have three question marks talking to Sia.
Remember when she beat Sia, the mask comes off and you see who she actually is.
Yeah. Yes, we are protected by a shield, naturally.
Time distortion.
Yeah. I don't know why, but when they're in the shield and everything's going crazy, it kind of reminds me of that bit in Final Fantasy X where Seymour was showing everyone Xanarkand. It's Elden Bridge. So we have Ocarina of Time, Twilight Princess, and Skyward Sword. Yep. Unfortunately, we don't know where each of the links from each of those time periods are. So you can make up your own theories about where the links are. Maybe this is one of those situations where you can't meet yourself out. It creates a time paradox or something. You know.
Ironic, considering you can have two links.
Yeah.
A link from a child link as well.
Yeah, but then again, Link and Toon Link are completely different links, so maybe that's okay. But then again, I suppose they would all be different links, but I don't know.
Trying to explain time travel is very difficult.
Yeah, just don't try to explain time travel, Morty.
You're not Rick.
I am Rick Morty. You can be my Morty Morty. Now, let's get swifty, Morty. Go on, hit the button, Morty. Give me a beat.
Now, the only piece of a soul is one trapped by the Master Sword. That is frightening.
Thunderbolts of lightning?
Yep.
Sia had already claimed the
so there we go.
Separate ways?
Mm-hmm.
From Link, she stole the force of courage.
I thought, oh well. Wait, what is it called? Separate ways? Or
yes, it is.
Oh yeah. Yes, I can see it now. A Resident Evil Dynasty Warriors combination.
Isn't that what they call mercenaries?
Yeah. 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 Except that obviously you're on your own. You know, you don't have other units to help you out. Unless if you do a duo mode.
And it was through these gates that the monsters came. By opening these gates, Sia had released the fragment of evil spirit imprisoned in each of the other eras.
The task before the heroes was therefore to travel through each portal and close its gate.
Yeah, now we need to travel through portals.
Do you think we'll meet Wheatley?
Maybe. We can meet Wheatley, we can meet Shell, we can meet GLaDOS, we can meet Cave Johnson. And maybe we can meet some combustible lemons.
To burn your house down.
Yeah. Or, in this case, a bridge, a mountain, and a town. Okay. Oh, 12,000 plus rupees.
Nearly 2 million, my friend. Nearly 2 million.
Nearly 2 million. Yep.
Deku Spear. Prism Rod. Wooden Frame.
Wooden Frame.
Typhoon Harp.
And a Magic Hammer.
Right.
Wait, well, you can get rid of that Prism Rod, that new one.
Anything else you want me to get rid of?
No, just that. You can get rid of that Deku Spear for a start. Yeah, because we don't want you completing this game. We're just sticking with a wee small stick. And get rid of that Typhon Harp.
Well, yes. I did complete the majority of the child character's story in Dragon Quest V with
just a stick. Yeah.
With the Cypress stick.
Yeah, if he was a Pokemon, maybe that's who he evolves into, because we see the artwork for the child hero. Obviously, he's holding the Cypress stick, and when he grows up, he's wielding that big staff.
Obviously, I discarded the new one.
Discard the new one. And we've got a large Darknut sword that we cannot equip, but we can use it for materials, for badges.
So
okay, so that is it. That's us done.
Mountain?
Yep, that is us done the prologue, and this is where the game's going to split. We have Death Mountain here at the top. We have Twilight Princess sections for the middle, and we have Skyward Sword sections for the bottom. And obviously, since you're in the main control, unfortunately, you will not be as Link for the Ocarina of Time and Twilight Princess sections, only for Skyward Sword.
Well, Anga plays Impa before, so...
Yeah, so just make sure that you pick a character that you're okay with, you know?
I don't think I've used C...
You don't think you've used what? Don't think you've... it's got his SCS tails there. Okay.
Yeah, we'll go with that. I don't think I've used Lana before. Although this isn't the same Lana from Archer.
No.
You've not watched Archer yet, have you?
No.
I would recommend you watch it. It's quite funny. But anyway.
Yeah, anyway, well, that's it. We're going to end it there. We're not going to speak about Archer anymore or stuff. Next time, we are going to start off with the Ocarina of Time sections with Death Mountain. So, I've been God on 99. This guy's been
Mark.
And we'll see you guys in the next episode. So, we'll see you then.